In the spirit of the holidays, we take you to a major hub for shopping in the southwest of Tobago. That is Gulf City Mall in Lowlands. Now this year, you'll enjoy live entertainment as you complete your Christmas shopping. There's also a lot going on in other parts of the island, including art, tourism, and some exciting new initiatives. We'll tell you all about it in the next half hour. I'm Davia Chambers, and this is Let's Talk Tobago. The foundation of the construction industry is being strengthened with the opportunity for more skilled workers to be certified. The reopening of the Bethel Youth Centre is being seen as key to youth development in the community. And later, we stop in at the Scarborough Library facility to find out the winner of the Tobago Secondary School's art competition. These stories and more when Let's Talk Tobago returns.
There we go, to Tobago, that paradise, Bomba, Robinson Crusoe. And it is said, it's the land of tomorrow. Princess Margaret say, come to Tobago for holiday. Now the whole world say, come to Tobago for holiday.
As you know, Christmas celebrates the birth of Jesus Christ and is observed worldwide. Call it Noel or Navidad, in Tobago, it's a time for family, for giving, and a reflection on our lives, and of course, the new year ahead. From reflection to construction, our first story looks at the growth that's taking place in that sector. Now, a new initiative is bringing certification to both skilled and unskilled workers to enhance their lives and improve standards in the local industry. Caroline Wallace has more in this report.
Beginning January 15, 2018, skilled and unskilled persons in the construction industry in Tobago can gain certification through the Construction Certification Training Program. It's an initiative of the Division of Education, Innovation and Energy. The classes will be hosted at the Roxborough Trade Centre.
We wanted those who could impact that training and impact the lives of people in Tobago. So they suggested 7 best men. We didn't ask for women this time. So maybe further down the road we may ask. And they gave us the list and they gave us the phone numbers. And of the 7 that they sent, 5 actually came into the office and had conversations with us and showed willingness to participate, and I was happy about that. We know that they have the know-how, they can do it, but they need some skills to better prepare them to deliver the program to those persons who would register.
The division is seeking a minimum of 15 persons for each of the classes: masonry, carpentry, electrical and plumbing, totaling 60 students in the first cohort.
If in fact we accept the premise that it's through education that persons would be emancipated, then clearly those of us with the direct responsibility to facilitate such emancipation are the ones with the real task.
The program will run in layers. Skilled persons, 3 months. Semi-skilled persons, 6 months. And unskilled persons, 9 months.
We are seeing young persons, young men and young women who are sitting around doing nothing, idling. We say wasting time. And this is another avenue, another opportunity for which they can be engaged. We have to spread the word. We have to tell them this is something that they must become a part of. We have to preach it, we have to believe it, and we have to say it, and we have to send them to be part of the program.
The Division of Education, Innovation and Energy is partnering with the Division of Infrastructure, Quarries and the Environment and the Division of Community Development, Enterprise Development and Labor for the program. I'm Caroline Wallace for Let's Talk Tobago.
Construction of Gulf City Mall started in 2002. The mall officially opened its doors to the public, however, in 2006. From technology to clothes and shoes, jewelry, toys and baby items, shoppers have a wide range of options to choose from when they visit the mall. Now, stronger communities make a stronger country, and Tobago is forging closer ties with the United States with a focus on projects that will benefit our communities. Omidara Mills explains.
The Tobago House of Assembly has long had a good relationship with the U.S. Embassy, especially when it comes to disaster preparedness. In fostering closer ties with the THA and the island's communities, the embassy has appointed a U.S. Embassy liaison to Tobago, Kevin Ogley. In presenting his letter of appointment to the Chief Secretary Kelvin Charles, Mr. Ogley says that one of the embassy's top priorities for collaboration is security enhancement.
We believe that a more prosperous Americas, or a more secure Americas, helps us all. So from the U.S. Embassy talking to the Tobago House of Assembly, we're looking at projects that perhaps we can help with both the prosperity and the security of the region. So looking at tourism issues, looking at possibly law enforcement and crime issues.
Gender-based domestic violence is a global problem, with thousands of reported cases annually and thousands more unreported. Mr. Ogley says it's one of the main areas of concern which was discussed with the Chief Secretary.
And today I'm here talking about gender-based violence. Now that isn't a Tobago-specific issue, but that's an issue that affects all communities around the world, regardless of social economic factors, religious factors. But it's something that I wanted to address while I was here.
The new U.S. Embassy liaison to Tobago also held discussions with the Secretary of Health, Wellness and Family Development, Dr. Agatha Carrington. Now, Mr. Ogley is no stranger to the island, and he says he's been having an enjoyable experience thus far.
In previous years, the U.S. Embassy carried out projects related to law enforcement, educational exchanges, and visa application seminars. The closer ties between the embassy and the assembly is expected to bring mutual success and benefits to these organizations. I'm Amadara Mills for Let's Talk Tobago.
Gulf City Mall has something for everyone, and for the ladies, there's Pink Zebra. Whether it's casual wear or something unconventional yet chic to help you ring in the new year, they've got you covered. Now, in the last few months, efforts have been stepped up to boost the tourism sector in a number of areas, including incentives for hotel and guest house owners. And they are using the opportunity to improve and increase room stock. More in this report.
The tourism industry is being rekindled in Tobago. There has been a 50% increase in reimbursements for upgrades to accommodations through the newly relaunched Tobago Tourism Development Fund. Effective December 1, 2017, a subsidy of 5% is being provided by the government on interest charged by financial institutions for both new and restructured loans. The hope is that tourism-related businesses in Tobago will improve on their facilities and room stock or create new investments to attract more visitors.
The reimbursement of expenditure on the cost of work per room under the Trinidad and Tobago Hotel and Guest Room Stock Upgrade Program, we've increased it from 25% to 50%, so that we will now reimburse hotels and guest rooms who seek to modernize and improve their facilities will reimburse 50% of the cost of that modernization or upgrade. We also decided to double the maximum reimbursement limit from the existing $750,000 to $1.5 million.
Additionally, the maturity periods for new loans and for refinancing the tourism sector has been extended by commercial banks. From 7 years, it's now 15 years under the Tobago Tourism Development Fund.
Tourism-related business would make an application to any one of the four banks who would look at the creditworthiness of the business, and then, having agreed to refinance or provide a new loan to the business, it is then sent to the Exim Bank, who would just do some further vetting, and the guarantee is then provided by the Exim Bank on behalf of the government.
Reimbursement on the cost of work per room under the Small Approved Tourism Properties Program has also been increased. It's now 40% up from 20%. The maximum reimbursement limit has been stepped up from $75,000 to $150,000.
I want to challenge you, the stakeholders, the private sector, to take full advantage of these initiatives. These initiatives represent the government extending its hands to you, and we cannot walk hand in hand unless you extend your hands too.
As at November 30, 2017, the Trinidad and Tobago Tourism Business Development Limited has issued 19 letters of undertaking with a value of $37.6 million. This is backed by the capitalization of the Tobago Tourism Development Fund. I'm Caroline Wallace for Let's Talk Tobago.
We have to take a break, but when we return, the Bethel Youth Center reopens its doors. Don't go anywhere. Let's Talk Tobago. We'll be right back. Stay with us. The Gulf City Mall is not just about shopping. This season, the mall will be filled with the sounds of our very own string ensemble from the Mark of Excellence School of Music and the Tobago Euphonic Sound Steel Orchestra, among many other acts. You've got to come down and see it. So the Bethel Youth Center has been reopened. It's a moment the community has been looking forward to, as the center is critical to youth development in the area.
Residents of Bethel, especially the youth, once again have a space where they can meet and collaborate. You see, the Bethel Youth Development Center has been closed for the past 3 years, and just last week, its doors were reopened. Now, the community has a place to host positive activities aimed at further developing young people and, by extension, the island.
I'm happy that the Bethel Youth Development Center is being reopened. Right, and it must be noted, even while we did not have a physical space, we have programs that has been going on in the community and all of that. Cosmetology, we have the kite flying, as Laverne elaborated before. We have we had a vibrant Sunday school going on. But right now it is at the Bethel Community Center.
In 2018, programs like Culturing Ladies to Achieve Sophistication and Success by the Department of Sport and Youth Affairs will be hosted here. Additionally, skills development classes are also planned.
I didn't have a trade. I just basically jumped from one work to the next work. So I decided to actually go to the center and apply for the electrical certificate course. In doing so, I was allowed to work in places like Cano Bay and run electrical wires. I actually ended up doing some work for, not TSTT, but B-Mobile.
The center has a computer room, gaming room, classroom spaces, and a library. The young residents are being urged to make the best possible use of the center.
We're willing and we're ready, we're enthusiastic to work with the young people of Bethel and environs to make this center a vibrant, creative hub for young people to participate in programming.
The Bethel Youth Development Center will also be home to the Bethel Police Youth Club. I'm Keyshawn Wilson for Let's Talk Tobago.
One of the favorites at Gulf City Mall is Caribbean Jewelers. They speak the language of love. You can also find that perfect Christmas gift, customized pieces, even school rings. And you know, speaking of schools, the island students stopped in at the assembly chamber, but they were not guests. They were the ones debating issues affecting Tobago's development. Here's what they had to say.
Tobago's secondary students lent their ideas and voices to discussions on the island's development. They were part of the annual Assembly Youth Debate at the Assembly Chamber, where for a few hours they assumed the roles of the island's leaders, including the offices of Presiding Officer, Clerk of the House, Assemblyman, the Chief Secretary, and the Minority. This event is aimed at creating future leaders and giving them a greater appreciation of how Tobago is governed. The motion sought to address the island's economic challenges, and in particular, issues such as maintenance, the number of people employed in the public sector, agriculture, and entrepreneurship. One participant addressed the issue of sustainable farming methods.
The ministry's farming initiatives must be geared towards building the capacity of small-scale factors to implement sustainable farming practices. Madam Presiding Officer, You cannot, and I repeat, you cannot produce crops if there is no one to work on the farms. Agriculture engenders good sense, and if we estimate dignity by immediate usefulness, agriculture, the first noble science, will bloom.
Councillor Kershaw Peer contributed on education. She believes the island's schools should take up a bigger role in preparing up and coming entrepreneurs.
Madam Presiding Officer, we as young citizens have potential, talents, abilities, and creativity in various sectors in this education system can be compulsory to students who are determined to expose their business to the public and improve in the economic development in the country.
Kezia Franco, the representative for Kenan Bon Accord, had a unique perspective on economic development. She was the eventual winner of the debate.
Madam Presiding Officer, entrepreneurial activity is only one aspect in developing a sustainable society. The policies of the Tobago House of Assembly must address healthcare, youth development, education, physical infrastructure, security, tourism, and inter-island transportation. Why then, Madam Presiding Officer, when our country is in a recession, do we want to allocate more resources for entrepreneurs when there are so many other areas that we can put focus on?
In the end, the winners were awarded for their precision and debate points. I'm Kern De Freitas for Let's Talk Tobago.
Culture and creativity are also supported by Gulf City Mall, where you can usually find cultural performances and even art displays. In fact, the winning art pieces from the annual Tobago Secondary Schools competition, which is hosted by the Office of the Chief Secretary, are displayed right here at the Gulf City Mall. Now this, the growing number of type 2 diabetes cases in children are a cause for concern, and one NGO is helping young people adopt a much healthier lifestyle. With more details in this story.
A 2009 clinical study by the University of the West Indies researchers showed that some school children in Trinidad are either pre-diabetic or diabetic. The students had traces of glucose in their urine. When their family members were tested, it was revealed that they were also diabetics. These statistics were used to educate students of the Speyside High School at a recent diabetes forum. It was hosted at the school by the Rotary Club of Southwest Tobago. The students also learned how people develop diabetes and the associated symptoms.
They're feeling weak. What else? They're hungry. They're peeing plenty and then they're getting skinny. So those are four things you look out for. Four things you will notice in somebody who has diabetes. Some of them tend to sweat a lot also.
There are over 175,000 people with diabetes in Trinidad and Tobago, making it the second leading cause of death in the country. At the diabetes session, students also got information on how the disease can harm the body.
You all ever see anybody who lose a foot because of sugar? Right, so that is one of the things that could happen. You could lose your foot, you could go blind. Yes, the sugar, plenty of sugar will affect the eyes and you wouldn't be able to see. And you know what else could happen? Your two kidneys could stop working.
It's estimated that in Trinidad and Tobago, one quarter of the children ages 5 to 18 are either overweight or obese, making them at risk of developing type 2 diabetes. So children have been encouraged to start practicing healthy lifestyle habits.
And I want you to remember to eat right. Number one, eat right. Plenty water, fruits, vegetables. Exercise. So I expect you all to exercise a lot at school. And to help your parents in the garden at home. Not on the computer and the iPad and those things all afternoon. Those things will help.
Following the lectures, students had their blood pressure and blood glucose levels tested. The session was one of the activities for World Diabetes Day. It's hoped that educating young Tobagonians now will reduce the number of diabetic cases in the future. I'm Amadara Mills for Let's Talk Tobago.
Coming up next, we announce the winners of the Chief Secretary's Art Competition. Don't go anywhere. These stories and more when we return.
CIT Tobago, ready to provide your community with the highest degree of professional services in emergency response. Contact CIT Mariah at 660-0065 or CIT Speyside at 660-6096. CIT 24-hour services, emergencies, medical or other. CIT Pro, the new face of emergency management.
Art is really an expression of one's emotions and imagination. And in the last few months, the island's young people had free rein to express themselves with their media of choice in the Tobago Secondary School's art competition. Crystal George was at the prize-giving ceremony to find out who would take this year's top prize. Have a look.
The Office of the Chief Secretary recently hosted its annual Tobago Secondary School's art competition. The competition is open to Tobago Secondary School students ages 11 to 18 years who are challenged to produce and submit visual artwork. The Chief Secretary's Art Competition in its sixth year continues to be a very exciting event on the calendar. This year, 79 entries from six different schools were up for judging, but only 12 were chosen to create the Chief Secretary's calendar 2018. Speaking at the prize-giving ceremony, Chief Secretary, the Honorable Kelvin Charles, said the competition provided a platform for young, fresh, and upcoming talent in Tobago art space. He further added that the competition provides an opportunity for the young artists to create their artistic skills while contributing to a well-rounded curriculum at our schools. Take a look at this year's art competition feature presentation where the winner was also revealed.
Art is not something somebody could tell you to do, you know, just paint and be free. Whatever inspires you, do it.
Magnificent.
Unique.
Captivating.
It's that time of year again. The Chief Secretary's art competition is back. Now in its sixth year, secondary school students around Tobago have dabbled in various mediums such as digital media, oil paint on canvas, acrylics, ink, and even charcoal to bring to life picturesque paintings, creating their own unique masterpieces. So, journey with us as we take you through the highs, the lows, the techniques and forms that are used.
Art, in its broadest sense, is a form of communication. It's an act of expressing feelings, thoughts, and observations. Some purposes of art may be to express or communicate emotions and ideas, to explore and appreciate formal elements for their own sake, or to serve as representation. This year, 79 pieces were up for judging, making it the highest number to enter the competition. As per usual, no theme was given, so the students had the freedom to create without boundaries. So we asked, if the piece were to talk, what would it say?
Thank you for making me me.
I love the way you made me.
Courage carries you many places.
Keep going, try your best. This doesn't look as perfect as it does, as you think it should be, but with enough practice, you will get there.
Thank you for showing Trinidad and Tobago the talent that it can produce.
So would it be Speyside High School again? Would they walk away as winners of the 2017 Chief Secretary's Art Competition?
For the first time, I've seen digital art in the competition, which is good. The variety of pieces that we have is really nice. We have plenty of mixed media paintings, sculptures that we didn't have before. And so that's a good thing. Kudos to the teachers and students.
We would have produced excellent work that can indeed win, but it's all up to the judges, and the judges' decisions are final.
Would they walk away as winners of the 2017 Chief Secretary's Art Competition? But there can only be one winner. Let's hear how this piece inspired him and why the judges thought he deserved the opportunity to be on the front cover of the 2018 Office of the Chief Secretary's calendar. And the winner goes to...
My name is Shakiru James. The name of my piece was the Tobago Arnisfield Water Wheel. What inspired me to do this piece? Well, Tobago has a lot of cultural items and cultural views as well. So I just wanted to recap on the things that made Trinidad and Tobago or Tobago memorable. And also to inform the upcoming generation about the history of Tobago.
Year-old Shakiru hails from Signal Hill, Tobago, and comes from a family of artists. But even with his remarkable potential and natural ability, art for Shakiru is just a hobby, and he certainly didn't expect to win.
Well, I am really shocked right now. I really don't know what to say. I wasn't expecting this, but I'm very thankful for the win.
Defending champion Speyside High School did not win this year, but dominated the competition with 6 students being among the finalists, along with 3 students from Goodwood High School, 2 from Scarborough Secondary School, and 1 from Bishop's High School. I'm Crystal George for Let's Talk Tobago.
And it's now time to have your say, the segment of our program where we hear what you, the viewers, have to say. Today, we are asking, what's your favorite holiday and why? While you think about it, let's take a look at who had their say this week.
My favorite holiday is Christmas because the 25th is actually the birth of Jesus Christ.
Christmas.
There's food and thing and you have the people in the around coming to your house and seeing your place and come camaraderie and talk and everything and love in your house.
It's a time of giving, loving and sharing each other.
It's a time for loving, sharing and giving. And
because it's the birth of Jesus Christ and we are all preparing to get back where the kingdom is.
I love Christmas for the ham especially and the pastel and I don't know, just hanging out with my friends and having a good time.
When it's Boxing Day, you know, just to be with family and enjoy the best of life.
We close yet another edition of Let's Talk Tobago, and as always, we thank you for watching. Please email us with your comments or queries about the program, and be sure to visit our website, like us on Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. From our house to yours, I'm Davia Chambers, along with the Department of Information, Office of the Chief Secretary, Tobago House of Assembly, wishing you a safe and very productive week.